Howdy, YouTube! Yes, it's your friendly neighborhood Chef Shade Tree again. Yes, I had a very busy day. Yes, I've been putting a couple videos on today, but I made another video today, and for some odd reason, it lost it. Because I ended up doing so much today that I ended up laying my phone in the sun, because I was still recording something, and I laid my phone in the sun, talked to my neighbor, and went back to my phone, and my phone overheated. And I lost the video. But anyways, what I wanted to do a video was doing a video on was my dad's truck here. After I got done working on this thing today, as you know, I had to put a couple elbows in it. My dad wanted this thing in the shop. Well, thing of it is, my dad didn't really drive it all last year. This thing has been sitting out in the backyard. We pulled it out last year, but we didn't really do much with it anyways. It needed a oil pressure sensor put in it. And I got it for him, I think, a couple years ago. It wasn't this last year, but I got it the year before. So, it was here, but it never got done. So, he was bound and determined that we needed to get this thing in the shop. Well, before we got it in the shop, it sat out in the backyard until he got home here. And since his car was down, we had to get it out of the backyard. Well, when he went to start it up, it wouldn't start. Just fired up for a split second, and then it quit. Well, I crawled underneath of it, and the fuel pump wasn't kicking on. Well, I had to kickstart the fuel pump in it, get it going. I know. If your fuel pump is tied up, you have to replace it. Yada, yada, yada. Well, the thing of it is, when you got a fuel pump that sits, it's not been used, and it sits, and it gets tied up with a little piece of rust or, you know, whatever gets in the, whatever it does, all you have to do is unplug it and jump the wires back and forth. You can reverse the polarity on the pump, run it backwards, and then run it forward, run it backwards, until it frees up enough to where it'll run. And that's what I did with this. I hit it a couple times, got the pump free up, and we fired it up, and we ended up driving it to town and back last night, and he's been driving around, so the pump is fine in it. But today he wanted to get it in the shop, get the sensor put on, so I got that put on for him. He wanted to put this thing on. This is the EGR pressure sensor, DPFE. What's it called? The EGR pressure, line pressure, DPFE sensor. So you wanted to check it, or change it, get that changed. And there's a couple other things you want to do to it. But yesterday you put gas in it, and put fresh gas in it, whatnot. So that's what my video was about, was on my dad's truck, getting it out and getting them few things fixed on it so we can get it going back again. So I did this. After I did that, we got it going. I don't think this thing is leaking anymore, so I do believe we're good to go on this. So I was going to show you another right when I did the video, after I was doing the during the video of that thing, I had something else to show you, and that's the reason why I got sidetracked, which was working on this thing here. Yes, I got the, we got the mower going and everything. I used it, but the tire, as soon as you put air in it, went flat. It did have a tube in it. I pulled the tube out, and it was split. So, when we was in town last night, we ended up getting a new tube for it. So, I was going to do that today, but I got interrupted. The neighbor came over, and I talked to him, and I laid my phone. What happened was, I laid my phone right here in the direct sunlight, and when I come back, the phone would, phone had shut off and lost the video that I was making. But anyways, that's what I was doing. In the middle of that, I didn't get back to this because then I got on my convertible. So yeah, I had to go in and cool my phone down so I could do the video on this convertible. So by the time I got, well, I had pulled the convertible in the garage so I can work on it. I had to go in the house and take a break and cool down myself and cool my phone down so I could get this, get onto this. So that's the reason why the mower didn't get done today. But I hope, it's been a couple hours since I've started this thing up. I had to take another break to get supper done. We had pork chops for supper tonight, and So it's been a couple hours since this thing ran, so it should fire right up. Oh yeah, listen to that. Isn't that nice? Oh yeah, buddy. This thing is sounding awesome. Heck yeah. So yeah, that was my day today. All kinds of work done. I got my dad's car fixed. Got his truck fixed. I got this fixed. But I still got to work on that thing. I got to put the tube in it. So yeah, guys. Hope you like what all I did today. Sure doing a lot of work. I got a lot to do. I still got parts, like I said, in that box. I got parts for two more vehicles. And they will be in future videos. So, guys, I hope you guys had a good Saturday. I know mine was busy. It was pretty warm here today. So, thanks for watching. This is Chef Shade Tree. Catch you guys in the next one.